All right, let's finish this piece of crap hack known as Super Marvio World. It's supposed to be an impartial reviewer, but how can you be impartial when it's this? Somebody tell me that they can be impartial about this. I say, oh, well, you know what? I did like this. Yeah. So we gotta suffer through approximately another 19 minutes of this. Actually, just under 19 minutes, because the last couple of levels weren't ended, but I checked them anyway. I think I've mentioned before, my policy when it comes to reviewing incomplete hacks is, once I complete two consecutive non-edited levels, that's it, we did it. It's done. Finished. Thanks for coming. Unfortunately, that's not until Into the Vanilla Dome. So yeah, in case you didn't know, we're in the level formerly known as Vanilla Secret 1. No, not Vanilla Secret, Donut Secret 1. And this is the path to the key. Coincidentally. Per usual, we're gonna get the secret first. There's the keyhole. Did not edit the Donut Secret House, nor did he edit Vanilla Secret, or Donut Secret 2. Actually, no, he did edit Donut Secret 2. Because I checked, and it had been changed slightly, so I didn't have to go do it. I mean, at this stage, is it even worth me saying anything else about the hack itself? Really? Seriously? I mean, hey, as I mentioned, you know, in the last video, I'm being a bit of a douchebag on this one, but still. Because I think I have a right to be a douchebag when people are sending hacks that show that there was very little effort put into it whatsoever. And I'm sure I'll get a comment or a private saying, oh, well, you know, they're better now, the level's better now, I'm working on them, making them better. But, I mean, again, it's your first hack, and you've demonstrated clearly very little skill in making original levels. In fact, probably no skill in making original levels, since I think every single level in here that was edited. Every level that was edited, you know, let's be honest, was based pretty much completely on the original level from the original game. Anyway, we're getting there, kids, we're getting there, we're gonna get there. First of all, we will confirm, and I will, I just get to normalize it here, but we will confirm this is an unedited level, which it is. Saying anything, nothing to say. It's Donut Secret House. You've seen it. Probably seen it a trillion times. But again, like I said, I just get to normalize it because I'm pretty doggone sure Star Road was not edited, and I don't care if it was. I'm not doing it. Again, we check, figuring this is unedited, but yet it actually is edited a little bit. Emphasis on a little bit. Marked emphasis on just a little bit. That's a trap, so we're not even gonna worry about that. Even if it wasn't a trap, I don't care, I'm not going back and doing it again. hole in the middle of the level. Nice one let me go over the pipe, which is a plus. Okay, no, it really wasn't a plus, but still. I don't know how I said that with a straight face, either. Now there's the Power House. Real funny. However, he takes all the difficulty out of this level by giving us a star. Not just a star, several stars. Lots of stars. So effectively, he took all the difficulty out of this. Every bit of difficulty possible just got taken out of that single level. And then there's a coin bridge for no reason, which, you know, you don't need it. If he was trying to go for some kind of different look to the puzzle in this level, it might have helped if you changed perhaps where some of the places went, because it's still the same deal as before. You know, there's a piece that's there, but what do I care? Whoop-de-doo. Somebody go in here. That's a P-switch. I don't care. I'm gonna go in here. Brings me here. Fine. Which doesn't, you know, just moves you up here, and there's the exit. That first room had absolutely nothing redeeming for it. And you know what? If I want to get the secret exit, before we address sprite limits, yay, I'm gonna go get a couple of capes. It's a matter of despawn and bring him back. There's another cape. Thank you. Now the secret exit, again. There's no difficulty to it because of the fact that there's a star right here. The ceiling I don't think is as high, but I digress. Now this caught me off guard a couple times. Now the fishing boo, another enemy I hate with a burning passion, the fishing, as Rom Hack would call it, the fishing fish guy, which you can't kill apparently. Get in the door, thank you. Secret exit, there you go, done. Whoop-de-doo, top secret area. Oh, I'm sorry, the poorly hidden area. Well, at least he was willing to be honest about it. And again, same deal. Two of both power-ups and the Yoshi. You know, and giant pit for some reason. Next level. Oh, God. Sprite limits, yay. No. You got that all wrong, buddy. It's sprite limits, no. Why would you gimmick a level around the abuse of sprite limitations? Honestly. Even more so, why would you make it based off of the original Donut Planes 3 or whatever the heck this level is? Donut Planes 3. Does anybody really care at this point? Sprites in here. They've caused slowdown. Big deal. Give me something unique. I don't know. Give me anything other than this. But wait, there's still more. There's warning type B. I still don't get it. Tetranomes have strange behavior for some cause. Safe states are not recommended during the course. Again, it doesn't matter. He's talking about this course here. I'm supposed to, like, sneak through. Allow me to state for the record, it doesn't matter because you can break it. You can just go over the damn thing, and it's broken. is no need to worry about it. That pipe is broken, by the way. So whatever puzzle type thing you were going for, you just negated any difficulty it was gonna have by giving me a way around it. My god, that's a really tall freaking slanted pipe thing. Need the star unless you have Yoshi for this. It's a continuous star maker, of course. Next! Ambron Castle. I don't get it. Major lag here, I apologize. Fixed itself, though. This is another one that's based entirely off of the original. Plus, he basically gives away the path to the friggin' secret route, you know, the bonus. Which, again, unedited, and that takes you right to the next part. Here's a novel concept. This next part is completely unchanged. If I wanted to play this, I'd play the unhacked Super Mario World. Of course, Mort. Well, I believe this is Mort. I never get their names right, I really don't care. Easy. And so Mr. Mario had bet foul beast most timid, now he's out to see his fortune. Land that reflects his memories. Blah, 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 blah. There's no story to this. Now this is the last hack level. Mushroomy Pass. Oh, here's a novel oh, god. Guess what? It's a Mario 1 ripoff. Oh, heaven knows I haven't seen enough of these lately. Checking for attention to detail, which there is none. This is the only level in the hack that is mildly original. However, that does not excuse the fact that it is a blatant ripoff of 1-1 Super Mario Brothers, which everybody else and their dog has done. Need I say more? Now, I really have no idea how to get the secret, because, you know, there's a wall between the possible, you know, the location of the keyhole, but... I tell you what, man, this is ridiculous. You know, I mean, talk about a hack with no redeeming quality whatsoever. Minimal originality, minimal effort put in. You know, and there's still gonna be the time of the video between when I finally say screw it to the secret exit of this, and then I check Vanilla Dome 2, I check the Vanilla Ghost House. So I'll probably just edit that out. Like, I'll probably just delete that, just lop that bit off the end of the video. And I'll spend this time where I'm wandering around aimlessly, not sure of where he put the secret. I'll spend that time focusing more on my overall final review of this monstrosity of a first effort. Suffice it to say, not impressed. Nothing to call home about. In fact, probably, if you called home and told them about this, they'd call you a moron. So to file in 4K swords or whatever your name is, I think something like that. I would suggest start over, like completely over. Like, do us all a favor and remove this scourge from the face of the earth. Scourge from the face of the earth. Now that setup seemed worse. However, not much. You know, I've seen much worse. But it does not redeem the fact that this is a crappy hack. Here's the problem. I jump over that wall somehow. Probably involving the P-switch, now that I think about it. But I really don't care. So if there was more up the secret path, I don't care. I have no interest in continuing this project beyond this point. So, my overall summation of this project. Go to Super Mario World Central. Click on the little link that says Featured Hacks, and play about half a dozen of them. Game to end. Those are good hacks. Those have good level design. Then, try making stuff like that. Don't copy it, but make stuff like that. Do not use the original levels for inspiration. Excuse me. Do not use the original levels for inspiration. Nobody wants to play Vanilla Dome 1 Mark 5. You know? With that said, I apologize for being a douchebag. However, when people send me a piece of junk hacks like this, I feel as though I have no choice but to be a douchebag, I guess you'd say. I like getting good hacks, I hate getting sent crap hacks like this. That's my opinion. You can agree with me if you want, you can disagree with me if you feel you must. But in all honesty, this hack, in my honest opinion, sucks. And anybody who knows what good level design is will likely agree with me. So, with that said, I'm gonna sign out. I don't know if I'm gonna keep the rest of this in or not. It's about another minute. Just a little over another minute of this, I'll probably just keep it in. It's just me finishing this level, checking the start of the ghost house. So yeah, to all y'all watching, if you have hacks you want to send me a private message, and I, you know, with a download link, and I will add it to the list. For the love of God, make good hacks, please. Make it something playable, and not just a rehash of the old stuff. As well, check out What the Hack. Six members are all pretty much all contributing now. Most days of the week, all kinds of different ROM hack projects going on over there at What the Hack. Link, as always, in the description. Until next time, when I bring you more stuff here in the App Zone, I will talk to you guys later.